Oh, Let There is a light in my life. Lord, lighten my path. The light that will take me to the source of my blessing. The light that will take me to the source of my glorification. Put that light on my path. In the remaining 90 days to the end of this year, we have 3 months to the end of this year. Take me to the source of my life. The source that will flow out of my mouth. The everlasting source of blessing. Lighten my life. Take me to the source of my life. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray. I need you over my life. Lighten my life, O God. Lighten my life, O God. Lighten my life, O God. Lighten my journey, O God. The light that we have, O God. The light of God that will lighten my path. The light of God that will show me the way. The light my path. In the remaining 3 months, lighten my path. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We lift you high, O God, for your hands of power, for your mercy and your protection, for your hands of miracles now. We thank you because of the first day of October, this month of October, in 2017. Thank you for your promises on every life and every person. Thank you because you have upheld your promises in our lives, and you have upheld your covenant. You said to us in this church, none of us will die. And thank God we are alive today. Thank you, God of covenant. You said none of us will be found wanting in sickness. And none of us has been on sickness. You told us we will overcome. And we overcame in so many ways. Thank you, Jesus. You are a God that you talk and you follow your talk. You talk the talk, you walk the walk. You are ancient of days. You are the big God. And you are a God that hears everything. And nobody can speak too much to you. You flow all over the world. And God sees everywhere. And God hears and he hears and he hears. And he's a God that is limitless. He's limitless to the earth. He knows the amount of sand on the beach. He knows the amount of stars in the galaxy. He is a big God. And he's the God that he will host you. He will become your visitor and he will make you big. He will become your visitor and he will glorify your life. And God was a visitor to children, and that water became water. That fire became water. He went to Daniel in the lion's den, and the lion was not able to harm Daniel. The life of Mordecai, his death. You are a good God. For your protection of our lives. You are protection of our lives. Answer our prayers. Your amen should be sounding. Accept our thanksgiving in Jesus' name. All the sins that we have committed in the past 9 months, God has given us in Jesus' name. Empower us, O God. For the remaining 3 months in this year, today makes it 90 more days to the end of the year. That the year will end. I pray for your beloved. Doors of good things. Open those doors unto you. The Lord will open great doors unto you in Jesus' name. If you want God to open doors for you, just say amen. Doors of good things. The Lord will open it unto you. Amen. The door of problems. The door of problems. The door of Christ. The door of death. The Lord will shut it. The Lord will shut the doors of death. Amen. I like your amen now. The will of that letter of death. The way I mean. Letter of poverty. The way say. Letter of death. The way joy. Letter of criminal of court case. The letter of the enemy of your family. The
Iwe-iji.
The letter of storm.
Iwe-eku.
The letter of cry.
Niwaju emeka niwa.
In front of anyone here.
Oju on fire.
Amen. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, beloved of God, the man of God is praying for you. If there is any 3 months to the end of this year, if there's anybody who is in stagnancy, that position you have, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost,
take
your words from there in Jesus' name.
Oh, Shami.
The position of stagnancy that anyone is right now, I beg of you, O God. God, I beg of you for these people, O God. That predicament you had, I don't want. That man was in that sickness for 38 years. The man by Bethsaida, he was not happy, but he had option. He was just there by himself. He was just there. He went there and you healed him.
But
he was a blind man and the angel was passing by. And he called and he said, who is passing by?
They
said, it's Jesus. He was not liking the position. And he shouted, Jesus, I want mercy. And people ask him, what kind of mercy? Do you want money? He said, I don't want money. I want to receive my son. That position you are,
oh
God, take all that of that position. That stagnancy position, the Lord will take out of stagnancy. Some people are not saying anything. You are not happy about that situation. You are waiting at that time. And you are in tears and you are in
thought.
You don't want this predicament. That predicament you don't want. And that you are. I beg of you, God of hope. Whatever predicament you are, that you don't happy about. In 3 months,
at
the end of this day,
you are full of
God by yourself.
Come
out of the way that position.
Amen.
There is nothing you cannot use. Jonah did his own wish because he didn't want to go to the
Nineveh.
And they found a way. And there was a trap for him. And they threw him into the water. And the fish swallowed Jonah. And inside the fish, the fish took him to the shore. God, I want to use your hand of power. Whatever we have as our predicament, and we are not happy about it. Take all out of it. Take all out of that predicament. Our promised land. Our land of covenant. Our land of glory. Our land of success. Our land of blessing. Our land of
God is the only.
Take us to our land in the name of Jesus. Please, you need to say amen. When you get to a land flowing of milk and honey, you will not go into doing this and doing that anymore. You will see helper. You will see somebody that's going to be of help to your life. If you get to a promised land, that your thoughts will be coming to fulfillment. You don't know what we mean by promised land. It is a land.
Caleb.
He said, come, Joshua. It was you and I. We were witnesses in that land, in the Amalekites. And there were some people. Those 10 people, they brought bad news. It was you and I, Joshua. We brought the good news. That land is of milk and honey. It's of milk and honey. We did not scare them. That Mount Hebron will be given unto us. It is for me and my family.
40 years ago.
And that was just 40 years ago.
But
I'm 80 right now. And that promise has not been redeemed. People don't tell me right now. That's what Caleb just told Joshua. And Joshua came to Caleb. Now, this is a prayer for you. Your land of milk and honey. In the name of the Father and the Holy Ghost. For the rest of this year.
I
will take you there. Your bondage is losing in Jesus' name. As from today, whoever says it's not possible for you, and they say your way will not be open, the Lord will make them a mountain stone to your glory. A mountain stone to glory. The Lord will make them a mountain stone for you. That warfare that is so close to your life. It's so close, like your carotid, your neck, your nerve, or your neck. I'm talking about your warfare that is so close to you. You cannot, it is a warfare that you cannot run away from. That warfare knows your in and out. The warfare that knows when you are laughing and when you are in deep tears. The warfare that is acting as an agent of the darkness. You better say amen. This is a prayer. In 7 days, in the name of Jesus, the Lord shall do that warfare. The Lord said I should read that prayer twice. So say the Lord of hosts. The warfare that is so close to you. It is like the nerve on your neck. It is the warfare you cannot run away from. The warfare that knows when you are eating. He knows when you are drinking. The warfare that knows your journey. It's a warfare that is reporting you to darkness. It's a warfare that comes and says it's okay. And see, it's also a warfare that sells you to other problems. That warfare that is like a snake. I pray for you in 7 days from today, October 1st, the warfare, the secret, openly the warfare in the name of Jesus. One more time, the Lord says, if these people can say 7 amen after the third prayer, if you can say 7 amen 7 times before the 7th day, He will reveal the secret of that problem. And God said, now, when He reveals that secret of that problem, be very calm, because God is going to expose secrets to you. When that secret is being exposed to you, there will be a light that comes at the end of the tunnel. And that light will show where the enemy has gathered your treasure. So that God can take you to that place. If you are not calm, you might not be able to get the end of it. Because if you are not calm, you will delay the work of God. I'm praying the third time that you will say amen 7 times. For the heart that is ready to be saved. If anyone that is close to you, they are close to you very, very close. Like the knife on your neck. And there are the people that are the warfare. They are the ones saving and they are hurting you. They are the ones blowing you and they are hurting you. There are people, you call them imposters. They are imposters. 7 people here. But you can say amen. 7 days. In the name of the Father. We render that prayer this year. Oh, sorry. We render that prayer here. About 2 years ago. A woman is here in this midst. And the man who was the leader or the chain or the chief of our problems. From Nigeria, they called that woman. Woman, we are sorry, we did some things in the journey of your life. And after that man reviewed everything, the man, he died. And this is 7 days that God is saying. In the name of Jesus. In 7 days.